Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Health and Diseases. In that, we are studying topic AIDS. Now when I say about AIDS, the full form is Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. How does it happen and what is its causative agent? Let's try and find out about them. AIDS. Now AIDS, the full form goes Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. Whenever an individual gets AIDS, his immune cells rapidly decrease, especially the T cells. Now T cells are those cells of the body which are at the higher level of the immune system. The two types of immune cells which get greatly reduced is the cytotoxic T cells and the helper T cell, that is TC cells and TH cells. The HIV virus, human immunodeficiency virus that causes AIDS, basically what it does is it has an enzyme which is reverse transcriptase. Whenever it attacks an individual, by using its enzyme reverse transcriptase, it converts its single-stranded RNA into double-stranded DNA inside the human host or human cell. And once that's done, it starts making its own machinery and stops or pauses all the other functions of the host. In this process, it tries and it eventually kills all the immune cells of the body. And once your T helper cells or TC cells are killed, there is no chance of you surviving. An AIDS patient eventually dies because of getting other diseases like tuberculosis, pneumonia, cold, cough, fever, or getting little immune diseases which you and me would get completely fine of, but an AIDS patient can have a tough time with it. Now, whenever somebody gets AIDS, the two tests that are taken or done are, the first test could be Vidal test, which is a preliminary test, and the confirmatory test is Western blot. And if your Western blot is confirmed or positive, then the person has sure got AIDS. Now AIDS could be latent or it could be full blown. The few symptoms of AIDS could be high fever, anxiety, anemia, and Kaposi sarcoma, which is present at the back of the individual. They are red patches which is basically present at the back of your body, which are a sign of AIDS. AIDS. The full form is Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. Basically, in AIDS, all your immune cells or fighter cells of your body reduce to very rapid level and which make you prone to other common diseases. A common cold also could be harmful or fatal to an AIDS patient. Now, AIDS is called as a slim disease. In AIDS, there is a rapid reduction in your weight and which is very prolonged, and the reduction is quite obvious and rapid. Now, AIDS is caused by a virus known as human immunodeficiency virus, and it is a retrovirus. When I say retrovirus, it has a single strand of RNA and an enzyme reverse transcriptase which it can use to convert into DNA, and that's what AIDS virus is special for. Now AIDS is characterized, or you can say the symptoms of AIDS are many, but One of the major symptoms when a blood test is done for AIDS patient in preliminary test is that there is a reduction in your T lymphocytes, or your fighter cells of your body, or T cells, will reduce to very rapid level. Now, why does that happen is that your AIDS virus basically targets this T helper cells and TC cells, and that number will reduce in your body to a very drastic level. So your blood cells, or your CBC, that is complete blood count, will show very less T cells. Now, this AIDS virus was first isolated in 1983 at the Pasteur Institute. Now, after that, there were many cases seen of AIDS around the globe and around the world. Now, infections of AIDS could spread due to only few reasons: handshaking, coughing, sharing tiffin, water bottles, or just talking to an individual who is affected by this virus will not cause you the disease. The few examples by which this disease could be caused is: 1. This virus can be present in large number in the semen as well as vaginal secretion and in blood of an infected person. And if any of these three is transferred by any other means, then a person can have AIDS. Now, AIDS could be either in full-blown disease or it could be in latent form. Now, when I say in latent form, in certain individuals what happens is that they get AIDS virus, but just to show that symptoms of AIDS, whether it is Kaposi sarcoma or reduction in weight loss, they take a very long time. I can say in simple manner that the AIDS virus goes inside their body but pauses or goes into hibernation. Now, that is a late, you can say a stop, or you can say a pause type of HIV, or you can say latent type of HIV. And when I say a full-blown AIDS, it means the person is almost infected by the virus. The virus is multiplying in their body at very rapid stage. There is a reduction in the fighter cells of the body, and Kaposi sarcoma is present. And the person would have got any of this disease. It could be tuberculosis, it could be normal cold and fever, it could be your pulmonary diseases, typhoid, anything. They are even prone to a normal cough. Students, this was about AIDS, which can be treatable. Now, the test which is available for AIDS is, the preliminary test is called as your Vidal test, whereas the confirmatory test is a Western blot test. In between this, there are certain tests, that is CBC is also done. The medicines that are available for AIDS, one of the type of medicines that is available is the AZT medicines. Now, this medicines basically stop the retrovirus. The retrovirus, or you can say, it stops the reverse transcriptase enzyme. If there is no reverse transcriptase, how will the HIV virus convert its single-stranded RNA into double-stranded DNA? That's what most of the AIDS medicines do. They don't kill the virus completely. They can only stop it to a certain levels. Basically, AIDS medicine try and cure the other diseases which an individual has acquired. Students, I hope you all are clear about this concept of what AIDS is and what are its different types and its viruses. Thank you.